So the final tower for level 6. This one's kind of a doozy. It's pretty big. It's got a bunch of one-way entrances. It's of course got monsters that can hurt us pretty badly, although the experience I built up with my armor in the meantime means they're not as bad as they were at the start of the level. We're close to 10,000 experience now. 10,000 defense now, sorry. Which means that the guys like these, which were kind of harmful before, now they're usually limited to 1500, 2000, 3000 damage a hit, so not too crazy. Something to keep in mind in this tower is that you really need to map it before you go in, because if you don't, you're going to waste a lot of keys and a lot of other stuff, especially due to these one-way entrances, which you see. You can see I just went through one of them. You're going to get lost, you're going to have to use a lot of keys to get back to where you were, and it's going to be troublesome. Thankfully I have spent a little time mapping out this place, so I know where to go. And I know that I can just shoot these guys because they only drop a candle, which isn't very useful. There we go. Now up here is the first bit of loot that we want to get from this tower, and it is a holy Bible. If you remember from the last time, those increase our wisdom. So our wisdom is now 45. Now it's 55. Oops. I wasn't planning to shoot that box and then get hit by the lamprey, but whatever. It's just a food guy, so I'm just going to ignore it for now. Actually, you know what? I'm not going to ignore it because I want to get a red potion. Red potions now are up to about 100,000 health for each use, so yeah, definitely very nice. I think these guys drop a key, so yeah, I do want to kill those with my sword. Keys at from this point on are not going to be a luxury. Here we go, another one-way entrance. This is the second bit of loot we are looking for in this tower. The another replacement shield. This guy is going to damage me quite a bit, but he drops a red potion as well, so again, worth it. This is a lance. Of course, we already have a better melee weapon, so we don't really need that, but we'll be able to sell it for quite a nice profit. This guy, on the other hand, is our large shield, which is exactly what we were looking for. Oops, I should have probably picked that up with my dig, but oh well. So let's get that equipped right away. Our defense now is 10,150. With our large shield, we drop a little bit, but of course our large shield has no experience on it yet. So that's why. Nagas, which are food, so we can shoot them. Let me see, where do we go from here? Down south, okay. So from here we'll go down and then to the right. These Eskimoids also drop a key, so again we'll wanna take out the last of them with our normal weapon. Pick up another lamp. No such thing as too many lamps. You can tell that these Eskimoids are really not that dangerous anymore. This guy just now did 225 damage, which is peanuts in our current situation. Lampreys. Yep, we wanna kill those with magic as well. Again, lampreys often just drop food. And from then on, we will go to the right. And this will take us back to where we came from. the place where we killed the bloodworms, the first bloodworms we encountered. And from here we'll be going down quite a bit. These raidens are also gold droppers, so again we'll use our spells to take care of them. Oh, you know what? I'm going to equip this one for a while. See how it works. You know what? That might not have been a good idea. But whatever. These owlbears were not important. And the next room is... Oh yeah. These guys also drop gold, but I think I'll use my sword to take care of them. Just to get some fighter experience, because they're pretty weak. They have a magic attack, but it's also pretty weak now. Let's see... Yep, we'll go down. And then down again. Let's try not to get hit. If we don't have to. I think these are gold again, so no worries taking them out with the spell attack. Yeah. And from here on we'll keep going down a little bit and then to the right. Yep. Again, gold spawns, so we can just take them out with our magic. We're gonna need to build up a little bit of experience on the corrosion spell anyway, so this will be good training. Oh wow. There's actually one left. That'll save us a little bit of food while we collect the boxes, although if he gets too close I'm just gonna kill him because we're down to 16,000 health again. Thanks to those stupid owlbears. Owlbears are really the only guys left in this stage that pose any sort of real threat, I guess. Although not that much yet, anyway. These guys drop a magic glove, of which we have... I mean, our halberd is already fully experienced, I think. Oh, it isn't. Oh well. It's strong enough, and... It's not worth wasting any health on trying to get a magic glove from these owlbears. Just because they're so strong. Next room, gold again. So again we'll use our mass extermination spells. There we go. Now this random little bit of gold that's here, it's always going to match the kind of gold that's dropped from normal enemies. So as you can see, these enemies drop 500 gold, then if there's any random gold lying around in the room, that's also going to be 500 gold. Let's see, what's down here? More raidens? Oh, just one. And some more bloodworms. Gold type, so let's just kill them. Just to make it easy for us to kill the last one. And from these bloodworms, yeah, we'd want to go further down. Some spare keys, thankfully. As you can see, we're burning through quite a lot of them. And, oh yeah, some more bloodworms. From here, we'll go to the left. Ooh, getting low on health. I think we better use another red potion. And that was actually kind of close. Yeah, there we go. Yep, okay, more bloodworms coming up. Yep, it's now official. Our wizard experience is twice that of our fighter experience. 300,000. Wait a minute, what's this guy? It's another gold guy. The next ones aren't a gold spawn, but they drop nothing of import, so Oops, did I need to do that? Eventually, I think so, yeah. I think we're coming back this way. Let's see. Lampreys, food. Again, got hurt a little bit more than we needed to, but oh well. And even more bloodworms. Giving us even more gold. There we go. There's some interesting rooms in this tower, which kind of give you various, like for example, there's a room which is, I guess, the armory or something. that just has a ton of low-level weapons in it, I think 7 hand axes or something, which obviously you wouldn't be able to use by this level. So yeah, just a couple of kind of weird rooms with weird items in them that you wouldn't really expect. Okay, so we're going further down, and then I believe from there on we'll go to the left again. Yeah, that's this one. These are the poison type Eskimoids, so that's why I'm killing them instantly again. We're actually getting pretty close to the boss room, I think. Yeah, I think so. Might even be able to make it in a single video this time. Yep, this way. Another one-way exit here, as you can see. Some more food. Pick up the stick. Yep, go to the left, right? Yeah, left. Come on. Okay, these guys again. I'm getting a little bit more fighter experience. And then, yep, left again. Raiden. You know what, I'm just going to rush a little bit to get to the boss room. Hopefully we'll be able to take it out before our time is up. We have to go south, and then south again. Oh my, the crystal ball. I completely forgot what that does. Must be magic resistance, I guess. 55? 65, yep. Plus 10 magic resistance, so that's very nice. Another plus 3 large shield, so I guess we didn't need to detour to get the other one earlier, but oh well. And this is it, time to face the boss. I am going to equip my stronger magic to fight this guy. And you will see that at this stage, these boss guys are actually getting kind of weak compared to the regular monsters we're facing. It's another version of the giant krill. But as you can see, our tilt spell makes very short work of him. And we have our reward, which is going to be a pickaxe, an elixir, or a mattock, sorry, and another large hammer, upgrading our strength even more. So that's it for this tower, guys. I won't be able to show you the way out because we're running out of time. I hope you enjoyed watching this, and I'll see you in the next part, in which we will probably be moving up to level 7. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one.